One of the most common misconceptions about medieval combat is that armor could be easily pierced. You can see knights in full plate armor or in chainmail being stabbed to death or cut in half all the time. And it's nonsense. Today we will demonstrate how it actually works in the real world and in the game as well. We have a lot of weapons, professionals, and also dangerous enemies that we're gonna cut in half and eat afterwards. Every weapon is good against different types of armor. In Kingdom Come, it's reflected in three different types of stats. We have blunt, slash, and stab damage for every piece of armor and weapon. Using sword against an opponent without an armor, wielding an axe gives you advantage in speed and distance, but using the same sword is pretty useless against full plate armor. Don't get me wrong, sword is a very deadly weapon. This is very sharp 14th century sword, and just look how easily it slices through this pick, which is very similar to human body. So you can see that one blow is enough for game over without proper protection. So now let's see how the sword deals with plate armor. So you can see that the combatant would be safe from bleeding and cuts. It withstood pretty heavy blows. Even the chainmail, and this is not a very expensive one, withstood stabbing and slashing here. The swords penetrated the gambeson easily, as you can see, but it's not failure of the chainmail. So you can fight with a sword against armor, and there are special techniques that can be used, and we have them in the game as well. But there is a better equipment for the fight with armored knight, like this hammer. So surprisingly, the armor withstood a lot. What's most surprising is that the sword is almost intact. There is a slightly damaged tip, and there is one little dent here, but even those massive blows to the armor didn't make a scratch on the blade, which is very surprising. You could saw that the pole arm penetrated the chainmail quite easily, so you'll be pretty screwed with just the chainmail and gambeson against this huge pole arm. So now let's take this down and see how the figurine ended up. These holes are from the pole arm, but the chest is intact. Even the warhammer didn't do any damage. Here we can see the stabbing of the sword, so it would be probably lethal. But you can see that the armor is pretty damn powerful, and full plate armor makes you a medieval tank, basically. The weapons we used during our little experiment are of course new, but this is very nice and extremely expensive collection of Jakub of 14th and 15th century weapons found in Bohemia. So these are really actual archaeological findings. For example, this is 14th century bastard sword with golden inlay. It's not heavy, it's heavier than a one-handed sword we used, but this is really, I never saw original sword. A lot of other weapons. The sword that we used is produced by the same smithy in Arma Epona as the sword that we are going to send to our backers, so you will get the same quality as this one. Yeah, there's a lot of interesting stuff. This is, for example, mystery cord that is used when the knight is down. You can like stab him in unprotected parts. So that's why it's called mystery cord. A couple of axes, keys, quest item. A lot of arrow and bolts, crossbow bolts. So this is really fucking awesome. So as you can see, it's very different than what many people think, and it works exactly the same way in our game. We have 3 types of damage, 4 layers of armor, and more than 30 damage zones on every character in the game. So it really matters where, how, and by what you hit your enemy. Every weapon has actually 3 attack numbers: how good it is in stabbing, how good it is in slashing, and how strong the weapon is when you make a blunt strike. Every weapon also has a different weight, which defines how fast it's gonna be and how much stamina you will need to use it. Each weapon and armor also have different quality, a stat that defines how easily it's gonna get damaged. That creates a lot of complexity and space for different fighting styles. If you want to see more about this, you can watch our previous armor and RPG video.